Last summer I bought this Bahu element for a bargain because the battery is short of that. But I figured I can probably find a way to replace the battery. And luckily I found a Google group where somebody explained how to do it. I think you should be fine doing this project with a Torx screwdriver and a soldering iron and of course the mystery box. And that's what's inside. The new battery. I guess you had a hunch. I ordered this from Aramid in Germany. I'm not really a battery expert, but it looks well made. Has a protection board up here. Everything looks properly soldered. So the first thing to do after ordering the battery is to open that thing. It has 8 screws in the back, so I guess removing them should do the job. The screws all had the same length, so no need to keep them in order. I just put them away somewhere. Remove those small connectors here. This one already removed itself. So that flat cable is glued on top of the battery, but think it's fine to just zip it off. Okay, and I guess this one is probably also glued in. I need 2 hands, but you get the idea. All right, now I cut it apart, and this is the actual battery. I guess it's glued in place somehow. It's just impossible to do this with filming with 1 hand. You can just like pop out the battery from the small plastic frame. We will need to keep this connector. Yeah, we will just keep the board. Doesn't really look like the protection board of the old battery is really soldered, more like point welded or something. I think I will just cut one side off, then I can short the battery out. And probably the other side as well. So I ripped the remaining metal foil off, and now it's just connecting the new battery to the board. Easy peasy, right? Sort of. I mean, some people did that apparently, and it works. But the guy in the Google group recommends to bypass that little chip here, or remove it. And if some random person from the internet says I should do something, I'll do it. That's how we do things, right? Check this out. I have both hands free. So B plus connects to P plus over here. But B minus does not directly connect to P minus because it goes through this IC first. So the outside of this IC connects to P minus. And we want our battery with the protection board it's shipped with to connect to P plus and P minus. So we can solder one strand here, the plus side, but the minus part needs to go here. So we will have to get rid of this chip. There's like almost no solder to remove here. Not really sure if I need this solder sucker. But I have it! Maybe I'll just rip the chip off. Yeah, I think I cut the rest off. And all you need for this is a proper Swedish carving knife. I guess. This is how the pros do it. Oops. Wiggle, wiggle. And it's like those middle pins you want to connect it to. Yeah, looks good. Outer ones. No, they don't say anything. So, yeah, it's like the 2 middle ones. The new battery goes in here, and then the old protection board that we use as an adapter goes up here. There's not super much space. I think it will fit. I mean, I know it fits because that guy did it. But yeah, I'll probably just cut off this structure here and then I have more wiggle room. And the carving knife strikes again. And that, my friends, is proper wiggle room right there. enough space for the old board. I think I'll put the battery in upside down like this. Then the board can go on top here. The red wire can just stay as long as it is, and I will cut off a little bit of the black wire. Now I could actually use a third hand. Maybe I will glue the cable in place first. And once more, adhesive tape saves the day. If you wonder, I actually scratched away the contacts next to the one I'm soldering, just to make sure. And the other one. Now it's all wrapped up in adhesive tape, nice and clean, sort of. It can go up here. Now I connect it again. Make sure it doesn't move around so much without the frame that I removed. I just put in a little bit of this bubble wrap that the battery came in. All right, time to close it. And the moment of truth. Let's see. I guess that worked. I didn't put the bubble wrap in the end, by the way. Didn't feel like I need to. Nothing is rattling or shaking inside. Okay, this is how you can repair a Wahoo element if your battery is dead. So the Wahoo is charging now. But if you want to see more master carving in the future, please like and subscribe. And yeah, have fun. Ciao. Yeah.